So, Fortnit. Yes, I'm playing it once again. Now, don't jump to the conclusions. I know the last time you played it might have been dog shit, but I actually think that it's gotten better. So that's why in this video I'm going to be reviewing it to, I don't know, I guess make you guys change your mind or make you stay away from it. And if you hear things in the background of the audio, well, that's just my retarded ass neighbors. My window's open. Sorry, I'm not gonna close it. It's just super hot up here. Anyways, it really changed a lot. There's a lot of car. Well, they added cars to the game. The last time I played, cars did not exist in this game. Well, they did, but not drivable. You could play the radio on it, even real music. That's like, I don't know how to describe it. Music that we listen to in real life, instead of just the regular Fortnite made up stupid music. The building is pretty much the same. There's not as much tryhards, to be honest. I think that's because they team you up with people that are around your same skill level. So if you're shit at building, then they're probably gonna be shit at building too. So that's pretty good. Skins, there's not really, I don't know, it's all the same thing. I'm not really gonna buy them anymore. That's what made me get away from them a lot. But I have noticed that the V-Bucks are a lot cheaper if you want to buy skins. I think like 33% cheaper, or 60 cents, I can't remember, one of those. Yeah, I think you only pay 60. Anyways, that doesn't matter. The battle pass, there's a new Marvel crossover. That's what mainly grasped my attention, the fact that there's a Marvel crossover, and it's canon to the main Marvel universe, which is, I don't know how you feel about that. I don't really care that much. Pretty sure they're not gonna do much about it. Probably just be another dimension that they'll refer to at certain points. Not sure. But I do want to say that is pretty funny, because in the movies, I don't know, pretty sure they won't integrate it into the movies, but in the movies, Thor was playing Fortnite, so maybe he'll travel into his own game that he's played. Anyways, diverging from that, there's a new event I'm more than certain that's coming with the Galactus. Now, this is not the first game that Galactus has been in, but I'll probably title that video for, you know, the clickbaits. First game that Galactus has been in. And, also, forgive me, please. I don't write scripts. I just say it off the top of my head, to be honest, or things that I was planning on saying, and then I'll say them after. The LTMs, there's not really as much LTMs coming through as before. The LTMs that they do have are pretty fun. There's a Marvel fight where you just get a bunch of superhero powers, and not from the same character, but from different superheroes that are in the game, or characters that are also not in the game. Some places in the Marvel universe are being teleported into the Fortnite universe, like Tony Stark's laboratory, the Black Panther giant-ass statue, a giant dog shed. I'm pretty sure that's the Ant-Man location, and I'm pretty sure there's not anymore. Also, you could read a comic that's canon, so if you want to catch up to your Thor comics, check out Fortnite to read a canon Thor comic. So yeah, really, I think that's pretty much it for what I wanted to say. If you want to stick around and see me catch a dub, not catch a dub, I'm not sure yet. You're more than welcome to. And peace.
and it's my dream to stay.